Good morning students, how are you? I am Francis sir and today we will be studying standard 7 geography and this is the fourth part of the video. Okay, so in the previous videos you know we did study about different type of factors you know which affect the weather and climate of a place. For example, the temperature, yes, winds, why do the winds blow, the different pressure wells generated in the earth because of the difference in the temperature. And today we will be seeing that how does the moisture content presence in the air, you know, affect the climate of a place. So this moisture content, you know, when it is present in a particular place, if it is high, you know, it generally tends to bring rainfall. So when rainfall comes, you know, we need to understand what are the different types of rainfall also. So basically, today's lecture is based on rainfall and the different types of rainfall. So the first type of rainfall that we can see is the relief rainfall, and the second one is our conventional rainfall, and the third type of rainfall is the cyclonic rainfall. So let's talk about this relief rainfall. Generally, how does this rainfall occur? Rainfall occurs because of the formation of clouds. You cannot imagine rainfall without clouds. Okay, so this is a very important factor. You know, formation of clouds or rainfall. So formation of clouds happen in the similar way in almost all the cases. In all the three cases, the formation of clouds is same. You know, there is a big water body, just like rivers, maybe big rivers, ocean, seas, like we have in the Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean near to India. So these are the huge water bodies. When these water bodies get heated up very far, very much, you know, the water evaporates and they move up, they rise up into the atmosphere, and when they rise up in the atmosphere, they cool down to form water droplets in the air, and this group of water droplets can be termed as clouds. So this is the way the clouds are formed. Okay, so we know that if we have, this is the land area and this is the water body area, that means maybe sea, or you can say any water body. Since we have a low pressure created in the land area because of excessive heating, and there is high pressure, in the areas of the water bodies. So what happens? This wind generally tend to blow towards the land. Please understand this. This wind tends to blow towards the land, along with the clouds. That are formed over the water bodies. Understand this. The clouds are formed over the water bodies, and since we have a low pressure area in the land, and water has a high pressure area, so the air from the high pressure area, that means over the water bodies, this air from over the water bodies tend to move towards the this land area, which is the low pressure area, and therefore the clouds which are present over the water bodies moves towards the land. Along with the wind which is flowing from the water bodies towards the land. So this is what happens, that the clouds that are formed in the water bodies move towards the land. And after they have moved towards the land, sometimes these clouds face an obstruction, just like a mountain. These clouds which are moving towards the land, sometimes they face what? They face an obstruction which does not allow the clouds to move So what they do, they ascend upwards. They ascend upwards, and when they move upwards, they furthermore condense. And when they furthermore condense, it brings rainfall. It brings rainfall in this side. Okay, on the side on which the cloud has struck. So this is called relief rainfall. So this type of rainfall which occurs when it brings rainfall on one side of the mountain, whereas the other side, this area, you know, it does not receive any rainfall. It does not receive any rainfall. Okay. So this is called rain shadow area. What it is called? Rain shadow region. What is called? Rain shadow region. Okay. So this is our rain shadow region, and this is called our leeward side. Leeward side. Leeward side. So this is leeward side. So the rainfall falls on the leeward side, whereas the other side, you know, it is a rain shadow area. A very good example of this can be seen in the Western Ghats in India. The Western Ghats, the triangular portion of southern. This is, we have Arabian Sea here, Indian Ocean here, and this one we have Bay of Bengal. So we know that at this side, you know, near to the Arabian Sea, we have Western Ghats near to the coastal area. We, with this coastal areas, receive plenty full of rainfall because of this mountains. You know, this does not allow the rain clouds to move to that side. Whereas this side, you know, this side receives almost no rainfall. And what we see that this side, you know, they are almost facing drought conditions. What condition? Drought. Drought. Sukha. Sukha ka condition hota hai. Dusri taraf ek taraf pani zyada hoti hai, barsha zyada hoti hai, aur ek taraf ekdam saaf pani nahi padta hai. So it's no rainfall at all on the other side. So they receive drought like condition. Okay. So this experience or this condition arises because of this relief rainfall condition. Okay. This is one of the rainfall that occurs in our nature. Okay. The second one is called the conventional rainfall. This conventional rainfall, you know, what you do, there are these clouds again move from the water body. Here, this is our water body. You can see that this is the water body, and here, you know, water vapor is rising and clouds are formed. And you can see that these clouds are moving towards the land. Again, these are moving towards the land. So these clouds, you know, when they move land area, they don't have to face any of such type of mountains. Slowly, what happens? They get cooled down by themselves, and while they move, they keep on receiving some rainfall. They keep on bringing some rainfall on the path. And jahan wo jaate hain, wo udhar rainfall karte hain. So this is a normal type of rainfall which happens. Okay. So this is called conventional rainfall. So generally, the clouds again, you know, move from the high pressure area to the low pressure area, and they bring rainfall in the land areas, you know, from wherever they come. Okay. So this is the conventional type of rainfall. Then the third type is about the cyclonic rainfall. You, by the name only, you understand the rainfall which is brought about by a cyclone. The rainfall which is brought about by the cyclone. Generally, what happens in the oceans, like we have Bay of Bengal or Indian Ocean or the Arabian Sea, sometimes there is excessive heating happens. And when this excessive heating happens, what happens is there a cyclone is created. What is created? Cyclone is created. Cyclone is a, you know, low pressure belt surrounded by a whirling wind. Cyclone is what? A low pressure area surrounded by a whirling wind. So this type of cyclone is created over the seas, And since excessive heating is happening, you know, it bears, start to bear clouds, you know. Clouds formation also happens and clouds are also formed. Cyclone-plus clouds are formed. When this happens, these ranges, this cyclone tends to move towards the land after its formation. And when it moves towards the land, these clouds also come along with it, and this will bring rainfall in the land. This brings rainfall towards the land. You might have heard about it in Goa, might have heard in India that there are almost in a year, you know, 2-3 cyclone comes. Yes, why it is? Because you know, excessive heating happens in the seas and the rainfall is formed because of that cyclone which is formed. Okay, so these are the different types of rainfall which is caused by the different modes of nature. Okay, so it is a very important aspect to have rainfall, you know, because we directly depend upon the rainfall for a pure water, you know, because rainfall is the only source of pure water. Even groundwater that we use generally, it will be over if we don't have any rainfall. Okay, groundwater will be depleted. So in order to recharge the groundwater also, we are dependent on the rainfall. So rainfall is very important. Now the next topic is the significance of weather and climate. Yes, we know that weather and climate are very, very important to us. It affects us in different ways. For example, in our daily life also, for agriculture also, the source of pure water also. Means all the ways, you know, weather and climates are very, very important for us. Okay, so with this we end this chapter. I would like you to go through this chapter, and if you have any doubt, you know, you could ask us or let us know, so that we could clarify your doubts. Okay, see you in the next video. Goodbye.